can clap your hands if you want to. You can stand if you want to. If you just eaten, maybe good to stand and move a bit.
Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King, His love endures forever. For He is good, He is above all things, His love sun. His love endures forever, and by the grace of God, we will carry on. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise.
Praise the Lord,
sing praise, sing praise
forever. Again, Psalm 118 verse 1 says what? Together with me? Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His love and yours forever. Praise the Lord. And truly, indeed, God is great, He's glorious, He's wonderfully strong. And right now, we just want to lift His name on high, lift the name of Jesus on high and declare His greatness, His goodness, His mercy and His love. How great is our God? Let's sing together, the splendor of a king.
The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice.
He wraps himself in light.
He wraps himself in light, and darkness rises.
God.
How great is our God.
St. Paul tells us in Philippians 2, Jesus' state was divine, yet he did not cling to equality with God, but emptied himself and became man. And humbler even yet, even to accepting death on a cross. But God, by his power, raised him on high and gave him the name above all names, so that all creation in heaven, on earth, under the earth, should bend the knee, should bow the knee at the name of Jesus. And every tongue confess, Jesus Christ is Lord. Tonight, we want to bend our knee. We want to bow down before the Lord Jesus. We want to declare, and not just declare silently. Like Father Bobby says, say it out loud. Declare, Jesus Christ is Lord. Can we say that? Jesus Christ is Lord. One more time, louder. Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. So right now, with all our hearts, we come to the Lord, we bow down and surrender to Him as we sing out this beautiful song of praise and adoration. We all bow down. Together now.
Princes and fathers, sons and daughters, kneel at the throne of grace. Losers and winners, saints and sinners, someday we'll see His face.
Oh, let's all bow down.
They all
out loud, awesome and holy.
Awesome and holy, a friend to the lonely, forever His love will reign. And we all bow down. Kings will surrender their crowns and worship Jesus, for He is the love, unfailing love. He is the love of God.
He's the light of the world.
Kings will surrender their crowns and worship Jesus. Worship Jesus. Worship Jesus. For He is the love.
We, Your people, bow down before Your holy presence. We give You our hearts tonight. We thank You for Your love. We thank You for Your mercy that saves us, for Your precious blood that delivers us from sin and death, for the power of Your resurrection to give us new life, and the power of Your Spirit to help us to be holy. Lord Jesus, as we continue this Lenten season, we ask that You help us, Lord, to have a deeper appreciation of Your great love for us. Help us, Lord, never to take You for granted, but help us, Lord, to always love You, serve You, seek to do Your will always. As we sing this beautiful hymn of worship and adoration, above all.
Oh,
Like a rose, gentle.
Like a rose,
gently. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. For you are the Son of God who loved us and gave your life for us. Our heart bursts forth with joy, gratitude, and knowing that you died to save us, knowing that we are held in the palm of your hands, we can rejoice. We can experience the fullness of your peace. For you, Jesus, are our peace. Amen. Okay, so I think most people are back already. So now this is our, that was our singing practice. And now we do the actual praise and worship. So, I hope you all got what you wanted. You want to sing and praise God, right? Amen?
Yes.
Do you want to sing and praise God?
Yes.
You want to worship Jesus? Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, so now let's sing our first actual praise and worship song today. We want to look at Jesus. Look at Jesus. Look at Him. Look on the one whom we have pierced. And look on Him without the handphone going off. Huh? Look on Jesus. Look at Jesus. The one whom we have pierced. Zechariah, I don't know which verse, which chapter, which verse. But Zechariah talks about it. They will look on the one that they have pierced. Look at Jesus on the cross. Look into His face, His beautiful face. His face, His eyes that are filled with tenderness and mercy for us, but now disfigured with beatings and scourging, the blood running down His cheeks. Look at His eyes of love for us. How do we respond to Jesus? We just tell the Lord, Lord, I thank you for your sacrifice. I thank you for loving me so much. Forgive me, Lord, for I have sinned against you, for I have ignored the many occasions where you called me to a new relationship with you. I choose to change, Lord. I choose to rejoice in you. I choose to trust in you. I choose to take you as my Lord and Savior. I choose to dwell in your peace always. So let us sing this song of praises to the Lord Jesus as we declare, only in Christ are we saved, in Christ alone.
Thank you.
with faith. We sing. Praise the Lord. Truly, in the power of Christ, we'll stand, we'll live, we'll love. In Him, we live and move and have our being. Praise the Lord. Amen. So now, as we sing our final song before we begin Mass, if you want to sit down, you can sit down. Or you want to stand, also can. Up to you. So sit down means song is a bit more solemn. So, Jesus, we come before you. You teach us through your servant David in Psalm 22, the Lord is enthroned on the praises of his people. Tonight, Lord, as we praise you, we build a throne for you to dwell in our midst. And we are here, Lord, we are here. We have no other desire but to love you and worship you. We have no other drive except to be in your presence, to be healed and renewed and loved by you, Jesus. So here we are, Lord, in all our woundedness, our brokenness, we just want to worship you. We just want to thank you. Father said just now, always be thankful, Colossians 3:15. With all our hearts, we thank the Lord. We thank you, Jesus. And we lift our hands to you as we sing. And here we are, lifting our hands to you.
And worship your holy name.
Hearts are suitably prepared and surrendered to Jesus. It's time for us to celebrate the Eucharist. Let us stand for our entrance hymn, Save Your People.
My steps be guided by your words. May evil never rule me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
As we have come to celebrate the Eucharist, we should know one important thing, a beautiful observation, in fact, from the institution of the Eucharist, the first Mass. We know two very important things took place during the first Mass. One of the apostles, John his name, he was raised to the climax of his discipleship. Image is clear. He was leaning onto the bosom of the Lord, giving love, receiving love. That can be called as the climax of discipleship of anyone, to experience the heartbeat of the Master. That happened during the first Mass. Another important thing that happened is, having received the bread, Satan entered into Judas, and he left the Lord for good. He went out. It was night for him. He lost his disciples. That also happened during the first Mass, rather the institution of the Eucharist. From this we get the message, the rise or the fall of your discipleship depends on your relationship with the Eucharist, to the Eucharist. How you take the Eucharist, how you approach the Eucharist. Are you preparing yourself to participate in the Eucharist, or you are taking it casually, taking it for granted, being in sin, coming for the celebration, receiving communion without preparation? Or are you literally prepared? Because your love for the Eucharist determines your occasion, your spiritual growth. Many people, because of unprepared reception of Holy Communion, unholy reception of Holy Communion, becomes like a piece of stone put in water. Nothing touches you anymore. Word of God, you cannot receive, you cannot read. You become very dry. Reason is this: unworthy reception of the Holy Communion. So that is why I would say the most tragic sentence ever written in the Bible is this: having received the bread, Satan entered in Judas. Jesus gave himself, Judas received Satan. Jesus was giving life, Judas received death. Jesus was giving joy and peace, what he received was hatred and division. Jesus is light, he received darkness. Reason: money was his first love. He was with Jesus, received word of God, but he was not transformed. Inordinate attachment to money, it destroyed him. With trembling and fear, we should approach the Eucharist. Because Bible says, anyone who receives the body and blood of Jesus in an unworthy manner receives their own condemnation. That's why many of you are already dead and many are sick. St. Paul is reminding us, asking pardon for all our sins with a lot of humility. Let us acknowledge our unworthiness and seek God's mercy, praying, I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters. In what I have done, what I have failed to do,
through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask, blessed Mary, all the angels and saints, and you, to pray for me. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that schooled through Lenten observance, nourished by your word, through holy restraint, we may be devoted to you with all our heart and be ever united in prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "And now, Israel, take notice of the laws and customs that I teach you today, and observe them, that you may have life and may enter and take possession of the land that the Lord, the God of your fathers, is giving you. See, as the Lord my God has commanded me, I teach you the laws and customs that you are to observe in the land you are to enter and make your own. Keep them. Observe them, and they will demonstrate to the peoples your wisdom and understanding. When they come to know of all these laws, they will exclaim, 'No other people is as wise and prudent as this great nation.' And indeed, what great nation is there that has its gods so near as the Lord our God is to us whenever we call to him? And what great nation is there that had laws and customs to match this whole law that I put before you today? But take care what you do and be on your guard. Do not forget the things your eyes have seen, nor let them slip from your heart all the days of your life. Rather, tell them to your children and to your children's children." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He's out his word to the earth, and swiftly runs his command. He showers down snow white as wool. He scatters hoar frost like ashes. Decrees. He has not dealt thus with other nations. He has not taught them his decrees. Oh, praise the
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not imagine that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to complete them. I tell you solemnly, till heaven and earth disappear, not one dot, not one little stroke shall disappear from the law until its purpose is achieved. Therefore, the man who infringes even one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be considered the least in the kingdom of heaven. But the man who keeps them and teaches them will be considered great in the kingdom of heaven." Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the first reading today, we heard how Moses reminded people to be on their guard, telling, "Never forget the words that are entrusted to you, given to you, nor let them slip from your heart all the days of your life." Rather, you should meditate, you should observe, and you should teach your children and grandchildren so that you may have good life, long life in the land that God has given you to live. In Gospel, Jesus said, "I tell you solemnly, till heaven and earth disappear, Not one dot, not one little stroke shall disappear from the law until its purpose is achieved. Therefore, anyone who takes it for granted, anyone who tells others that it's okay to live your life whatever way you want, do not take this word of God very seriously, the laws, the commandments. You will be the least, but the man who keeps them, who obeys the word of God and teaches others, will be considered the great in the kingdom of heaven. Today, we had been meditating on the importance of keeping the word of God in our heart. And the Lord very clearly tells that every word that you read from the Bible is very important. Every word will come true. And so, you need to keep the word close to your heart so that you be able to see miracles. John 15:7, if you abide in me, how? If my words abide in you, then ask whatever you want. What will happen then? It shall be done for you. It shall be done for you. Meaning, if my words abide in you, ask whatever you want, and it shall be done for you. So our prayer should be, Lord, teach me your words. Help me to remember your word. I was asking a grace once, Lord, help me to learn the word of God, to learn the word, give a grace. Then I got a word of God from Psalm 119:73. Give me understanding that I may learn your word. So it's a beautiful prayer which I had the psalmist was doing that. Give me understanding that I may learn your word. Psalm 119:73. Hallelujah. In Psalm 119:11. I have laid up your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. Meaning, if you keep the word in your heart, we will not sin. The more you repeat word of God and learn word of God, addictions and habitual sins will drop. It will leave you. Like anger, addiction to pornography, masturbation tendencies, impure eyes, and laziness, slothfulness, all these things will leave you if you fill yourself with word. And there's a beautiful word, Psalm 119:16. I will delight in your words and I will not forget your word. I will not forget your word. It's a beautiful thing. Psalmist says, I will not forget your word. Psalm 119:16. So for that we should delight in the Lord. Delight. The word of God should become our delight. Psalm 119:47. I find my delight in your commandments, which I love. You should find delight in his words, in his promises. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And another beautiful word, Psalm 119:36. Incline my heart to your words and not to gain. Financial gain, other gains in the world. Incline my heart not to the gains, worldly things, but your word. Turn my eyes from looking at vanities. Give me life in your ways. Hallelujah. And a final word, keep close to your heart. The Lord is my portion. I promise to keep your words. Psalm 119, verse 57. Can you repeat? The Lord is my portion.
Lord is my portion.
I promise to keep your word.
I promise to keep your word.
The Lord is my portion.
The Lord is my portion.
I promise to keep your word. Hallelujah. Dear ones, today after the Eucharist, we will have a Eucharistic adoration and healing and deliverance prayer and laying of the hands, in which we seek the spirit of prayer, the spirit of peace and spirit of joy to take complete control over us by the merit of the Word of God that we have listened these days. It's a beautiful experience to be filled with peace and joy from within. It's a beautiful experience to be able to be joyful in the Lord all the time. All the saints really had received this grace, and it is not the luxury of the saints alone. He wants that each one of us should have this. So 1 Thessalonians 5:16, rejoice always. And for that, what we should do? Pray without ceasing. How is it possible? Give thanks in all circumstances. That is how it is possible. Keep on thanking God in all circumstances. Keep on thanking God. That is the expression of our joy. In all circumstances, even when we are misunderstood, thank you, Lord. Even when you have so much of pain, thank you, Lord. Even when your dear ones go away from you, thank you, Lord. Give thanks in all circumstances. Why? For this is the will of God concerning you in Christ Jesus. Nothing less, nothing shorter than this. This is the will of God concerning you. We are all called to be joyful. We are all called to be thankful. Let the peace of Christ rule your heart, to which you are called as one body, and be thankful. Name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thanksgiving hymn, These Alone Are Enough.
Take my heart.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the prayers of your people along with the sacrificial offerings, and defend those who celebrate your mysteries from every kind of danger, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim,
Holy,
Holy,
you are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting up, your sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, giving you thanks. He said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, William Goh, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this community whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, I am with him, and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to call him our Father, who art in heaven. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
May the receiving of your body and blood, Lord Jesus, not bring us to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy be for us protection in mind and body and a healing remedy. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Let us now sing our communion hymn, You Alone.
You alone are worthy. we receive the Lord in Holy Communion, let us open our hearts to Him. Let us hear Him in our silence of our hearts, telling us that we are loved, we are treasured, we are His sons and daughters. As we sing this hymn, O God, You Search Me, let us claim the fullness, the depth, the greatness of God's love for us.
you will show me the path of life. The fullness of joy is in your presence, O Lord. Let us pray. May the heavenly banquet at which we have been fed sanctify us, O Lord, and cleansing us of all errors, make us worthy of your promises from on high through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Give to your people, our God, a resolve that is pleasing to you. For by confirming them to your words, you bestow on them every favor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord through our lives.
Thanks be to God. And as we conclude our Eucharistic celebration, let us glory in the cross, verse 1 and verse 4.